plus DNA.
What animal would you copy if you could clone any living thing? Today, I'm going to tell you about some facts and pros and some cons about the scientific progress. Cloning is basically doubling the genetic code to get an exact copy of any living thing. Mostly in war plants. The first clone ever was a mouse in 1979. Have you ever heard about Dolly the sheep? Well, if you haven't, she was a fairly clone who might be the most famous in the whole world. She ate like a normal sheep. These days, scientists can clone any living thing. Now, let's talk about the pros of cloning. Scientists could bring back extinct species like the moa, dinosaurs, and the dumb dodo. Tragic. And observe them in real life. This is my favorite idea about cloning. It's getting clones yourself to do your homework. It's cool for you.
That would be awesome.
Scientists could also save endangered species that are close to extinction. Now, the cons about cloning. It takes many lives to make one clone. This is because it takes many tries to get a clone without defects. Scientists could bring back a dinosaur.
Asgard, Sarah!
And it's special meal, eat everything. Also, the scientists bring back a dead species that has a dangerous disease with plague or smallpox.
We could get infected.
And what if scientists go crazy? We're growing everything, my whole world, and then the clones
go take over the world!
So, are you guys gonna read
now we know that cloning can be good or bad.
You said total.
Skinny and mighty, which wouldn't be great.
Okay, so
people just need to think about the consequences.